Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny. Thanks for joining me today. We're going to watch lip injections where we're making the top lip larger to roughly approximate a 50-50 lip, and to get a little more protrusion of that upper lip and change the angle to fit with the chin and the nose. Let's go to the video now. So if I inject laterally, I'm going to give her a wider mouth. If I inject centrally, I'm going to give her a shorter mouth. I look at the masseter and I go, can she take a wide mouth? The models of the world typically have a wider mouth. Angelina Jolie, wider masseters, wider mouth. That's why she can take that. I like what we have. We're gonna, well, let's add some laterally, open up a little bit. And I know that it will look good. I'm injecting at the wet dry for her. Vertical lip lines are not an issue. So I don't need to inject the vermilion border or above. I watch it fill. Just because you put in 0.1 on one side and 0.1 on the other, it can be very different. So we want to, it's more what you see happen than what you, with the in the tissue, than what you see happen on the syringe numbers. The numbers don't mean much, but a combination of both is good to look at. Now, I know she needs a little more volume in the front. What I like to do to get a little E version of the front, I think it's going to look very nice for her, is flip the lip like this, come from inside, and I'm going to inject behind the wet dry, sorry, a little poke. I'm going to come not too deep, but anterior injections to the GK point. And I'll talk about that in a minute. What that's going to do is create a strip of product that curls, and this is retrograde now, it's going to curl that lip up. So here's your GK point where the filter column comes down to the lip, and we're injecting around that lip. It's kind of a technically difficult, but it's a good look. So if I look at her lip now, I'll see the front flipped here with very little product, 0.2 mL so far. On the bottom, I'm not going to go as lateral. I'm going to go more, I'm going to make her wider mouth on the top lip because I like that look, and less so, more on the bottom, it's going to be central. Open up a little bit, thank you. And I think that's going to look amazing for her, but we will assess it to make sure we're right, but I believe that that's going to look good. A lot of lip filler is the experience of the injector, but also the experience of the injector with the product. And see, she shook there for a minute. I knew I was near a nerve. So that tells me that we want that from our patients, because it tells us that the vessel might be close, so we don't inject when they do that. Pain control is important. So I like a little bit of pressure. Okay, so we're filling the other side now, similar to the other, little poke here. I'm gonna come lateral on the lip, antegrade injection, wet dry border, and retrograde, always looking at the mucosa and trying to get it symmetric, of course, with the other side. I'm coming all the way laterally here because I want a wider upper lip. So we're gonna come right to the edge. Here, again, antegrade up towards the GK point and then retrograde. And you're watching to see what the filling looks like with each one. Okay, now, I'm going to come posterior, inside, and I'm going to do that, the flip technique, coming superficial, antegrade technique to the GK point, antegrade and retrograde. It's a thin strip, and I'm going to look and see if I have the E version that I need, and it equals the other side. If not, I can always come at it. As I'm looking, I think there's two tubercles on the bottom, one, two, three on the top, one, two, three. I'm liking the central one on her. I rarely talk to my patients, I just do what I want to do, right? The poor girl is probably like, well, Rajani likes it, but I don't know if I do. But I'm just creating what I think will look good. So close a little bit, I'm going to inject, I'm liking the way this is looking in the front. And so I'm gonna play off that a little bit and create that, because the trend is your friend and the trend looks good. Always watch the columellar arteries here, and so we have to be careful not to occlude that either through compression or intravascular.
Okay, so same thing on this side. The GK points here, I'm gonna try and equal my other side. Okay, and then this is mainly retrograde here. If I was filling the exact center tubercle, I would ask the patient, because that is a look. So I wanted a little more eversion here on this side. I didn't get it the way I had the other side. So I come in and I go anterior to the wet dry to get a little more eversion of the top lip. I like her left better than her right. So I'm gonna make her right equal her left. So we like the volume here. I'm not sure that we're gonna fill the central tubercle, but we're gonna fill right at the GK point. And I often like the look of this. So yeah, you can come right here and you'll get a little poke coming right here, right at the GK, little poke here. It's a bit of a sensitive area, but it looks really good. And watch for the columellar vessel, but in general, you can put just not even a 0.1 at each GK, and you can move that. And then the next one, okay, got it. And the next one, we match that. And then when you watch, you'll just see that alone will create a projection of that upper lip. So we're going to finish up here with three things. Number one, I'm going to put a little volume in the central tubercle, but anterior. The other thing I'm going to do, the edge of the mouth, I like the way it's tilting up. Now I know it's going to relax a little bit, but supporting the modiolus here puts her a little more in a smile expression. So first one coming here, by putting this droplet, and we can do that because it's restless and defined, little poke coming here. What it's gonna do, it's gonna support that modiolus and keep the mouth in an upward turn. One of the things that people do not like is the downturn of the mouth. And if we can prevent it, she'll never have it. And funny enough, psychologically, just that upturn can make someone look more pleasant, more approachable, and actually affects their life in many ways. So the same thing on this side, a little poke coming here. And I put, with Define, you can do a bolus like this. It works very, very well. It's cohesive to the point where it stays, but she won't feel a bump or see a bump with the product. Now, I just like the trend here. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna add a little bit just to the front, little poke coming here. This is the most sensitive injection you'll do because it's all the nerve fibers from the right and the left come together. But she's a rock star, she's doing amazing. And just a little product, I got a little left, but I wanna see the trend of that. And I kinda like it a lot. So I'm gonna make her symmetric. So there's one more coming here. But you can see where with a product that like this that has a lot of G prime, a lot of strength to it, I can create things with very little effort. And I can see the filter column here. I just need a little at this point. So the product that you use really plays a role in the outcome of what we get. And there we go. I'm going to give it a final feel here. What am I feeling for? Lumps or bumps, irregularities. But I don't massage or feel much at all. Just a cursory kind of an idea, yeah, and hold a little pressure over that one spot. And then one of the most important things we're gonna do is get a 3D after picture so we can follow. If she likes it, we'll do more in the future. So there's a video of lip injections. Thanks for joining me. Go to our Instagram page for before and after pictures. Subscribe here. Let me know in the comments section below, what do you do? How do you like lip fillers done? Microcannula versus needle. And join me weekly for continued helpful tips to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.